Good morning. We had a bit of a rough night last night. Come here. This one had some bad dreams, so it was a bit of a rough night. And it is currently 5:59. Here, let me give you some light. Don't mind my appearance. But it is currently 5:59. Been up since probably around 3 with some broken sleep, so it's gonna be an interesting day. And then of course, like, our toddler still wakes up at night, so between her and my oldest, we are going to have a long day. Seeing my husband off to work here just can't be normal for the camera. Okay, bye dog. Have a good day.
It's Friday.
Yes, it is. All right. Well, let's get our day started. I'm going to drink some coffee. Just have just a slow morning. Yeah, you're taking me high. Ain't nobody like you. I apologize for the lighting since it is so early. It's pretty dark in here, but I have been doing this read through the Bible in 1 year from Rebecca Spooner. It's really, really cool. It takes you through the Bible in 1 year, starting with March 2020. And it's got like a little reading plan for every day. And so, like, just flipping through, you got like a little space to write what's on your heart. Got scripture memory if you want to memorize scripture, spiritual disciplines, like little prayer and praises. It's just a really simple reading plan from Rebecca Spooner, and I will link it down below, and it's completely free. So if you're interested in doing it, it's never too late to start. I mean, we're only 13 days in, and you can easily catch up at this point. So yeah, I will leave that down below if you're interested. Well, we've got another one up. And then we got another one up. And there's only one more to go. Sun's starting to come up, so it's not so dark. Yes, you say hi. Yeah. I hear another one coming down the stairs. Bubba. Is it Bubba? not gonna lie, we started the day off in a bit of a wrong foot, but we're gonna turn it around. Even though I am dead dog tired right now, we are going to turn it around and have a good day because it's Friday. And we're gonna get started because it is about 9 o'clock. So at least we're getting started somewhat on time for a usual day. And yeah. All right, so we're doing a topic sentence and a closing sentence for It's Raining Cats and Dogs for Real. That is the topic for the paragraph of the week that they're doing today. Bubba, you gotta get out your stuff here. So write a topic sentence, which is going to be the opening sentence of your paragraph.
Like what?
Like, okay, what are we talking about?
We're talking about it's raining cats and dogs.
Yep, it's raining cats and dogs. So how would you start that paragraph? And then your closing sentence is going to be the very end sentence. And then I am just having Maddie do... What are you trying?
Donna loves and she's a rock star.
Ooh. I'm just having Maddie do some like little free drawing right now. And we've got... What do you have in your mouth? Oh. Oh, she's singing into a microphone. She's pretending the glue stick is her microphone. And she's got one sock on. I just realized that Kaylin and Zoe are matching today. They both have the same rainbows and kitty cat designs on their shirts. While the kids work on that, I am going to work on our 24 family ways. We are on way two. We've been kind of hit and miss with this. We really do enjoy it, but we're also going through indescribable. So we've just kind of been changing it up as we're feeling it, you know. So what is our family way number one, you guys? We love and obey.
And obey.
Who?
Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Yeah, with
wholehearted devotion.
Great job. And then our family way number two is we read the Bible and pray to God every day with an open heart. So this is Elijah's handwriting workbook. It's one that I just ordered off Amazon because he finished his The Good and the Beautiful handwriting. Mainly cursive. And so it just kind of gives him some extra practice with his cursive. So today you are working on R. Aww.
Labrador.
Aww, just like Gracie, huh? It's the verse from John 13:34, and copy it in cursive. As good as handwriting as possible. All right, Maddie, do you want to go ahead and move on to handwriting, sweetheart?
Yeah.
Wherever it is, it's in there somewhere. Oh. You really need to organize this homeschooling room this weekend. Trace each letter and write each letter. So trace it and then write it. And then color each jewel a different color.
Okay.
All right, I've got Kaylin's math ready to go. And then Elijah.
Mama.
What?
I will probably get my rounding right again today.
Yeah, you did awesome yesterday with rounding. And Elijah, are you finishing up Freddie and Linda today?
This is the last chapter.
Ooh. You're just making a bunch of noise. All right, so as Maddie is finishing up her handwriting, I am going to go ahead and get her language arts and her math ready. And I like just kind of getting an overview of what we're going to be doing so that if I need to get anything out, I can go ahead and do that at this time. This girl's usually down for a nap when it comes time to do language arts, but I don't think she's quite. Yeah, she isn't quite ready yet. So we're gonna see if we could do this with her around. She's very loud. Then it looks like just some like review number 17 through 19. So
finish Freddie and Linda. High five. Yeah. All right, so the kids are getting snacks right now before moving on to their next lessons. So
Elijah will just do some busy work until it's time for him to do math, and Kaylin will do math, and then I will work with Maddie on language arts and math. So hers usually, if you've seen my other day in the lives, hers goes pretty quickly. We're usually finished with both within a half hour, so that's usually in good time, you know, for Zoe to be down for a nap, and then that way I can focus solely on her and teaching her, and then the other two do their more independent things until they're ready for language arts.
While the kids are having their snack, what I'm doing is I'm just creating quick little word searches for the kids. I use an online generator. This one's from thewordsearch.com. So I just put in spelling words, which these aren't all the spelling words that he's had. Some of these are just review. He really only has 4 spelling words this week because he knew all the other ones. So this is actually his last chart of spelling words. So we're gonna go ahead and go back through and just review all these other ones that he's had. But yeah, so this will kind of keep him busy until it's time for him to do math. And then I'll do the same for Kaylin as well. Kaylin's going to do math while Elijah works on his word search. You can even use crayons if you want to make it more colorful.
That's what I'm going to do.
Or not. All right, Kaylin needs a little bit of help with her math. So we've got 322 plus 245 plus 137. So you're going to start with the ones place. What's 5 plus 2?
7.
And what's 7 plus 7?
14.
Yes. So what are we going to put here?
4.
4. And we are going to carry the 1 up here. Okay, so what's 2 plus 1?
3.
What's 3 plus 4?
7.
And what's 7 plus 3?
Mm-hmm. 10.
Yep. Yeah. So put what here? 0. And you're carrying the 1 up here. What's 3 plus 1?
4.
What's 4 plus 2?
6.
What's 6 plus 1?
7.
Yep. So 7. The answer is 704. That's all you do, is you just add them together like that. All right, and then how is your spelling words coming? So you've got 50. Okay. Do you see any other words? How about December? Do you see December anywhere?
December.
Did you find it? So this is what we're going to do today. We are going to learn words that end with the following sound.
Am.
Good job. All right, now we're going to add a letter before the sound am. So go ahead and read these words.
Am, Sam, am, ham, j, m, and j, am, jam, y, am, yam, p, am, pam.
Good job. Now point to the words on the line above that start with an uppercase letter. So which of these words start with an uppercase letter, like a capital letter?
What is a capital letter?
It's the big ones. So like that one. No, that one's actually lowercase. That's lowercase. That's lowercase. And then is that one uppercase? These are names. Sam and Pam. And they are always uppercase. All right, now we are going to review words that end in the letters IT, which makes it. So go ahead and say these.
We feel so itchy. I'm right here.
Oh man, what are you so itchy for?
I don't know.
Why are your cheeks so red?
I don't know.
Oh man. You're a goofball. What are you? Ladybug. Ladybugs have those little things coming out of their mouth.
But speaking of ladybugs, there is a ladybug up there.
Let's look. Ooh.
Yeah.
That's 15. We got 15, 16, 17. Good job. And then color in 17 boxes on the 10 frame.
You'll be back again when the stars are aligned. We will dance in the meadow on our favorite place when spring is coming.
Fill in the missing words in the chart. So we were, remember when we were doing past tense yesterday?
Yeah.
All right, so we're gonna fill in the chart. So today my dog barks. Last week my dog.
Today my dog.
If it barks in present tense, what are we gonna do in past tense? Barked, right?
Mm-hmm.
So right, barked. Barked right there. Just lowercase b is fine.
I will save you a space for a dance in the meadow on our favorite place when spring is coming.
We are going to look at this painting, and why do you think the artist painted this? Let's look at it.
Because
it's called Entertainment for the Sick by Felix Schlesinger. It looks like somebody's sick in bed and like a bunch of kids are entertaining her, right?
Mm-hmm.
How does the artist make the painting look so realistic?
Because the people.
The people are really detailed, aren't they?
Mm-hmm.
One way is by using different shades of colors. Look at the white blanket on the bed. Did the artist use more than one shade of color on the blanket? It's not just like a pure white blanket, is it? There's like...
Mm-hmm.
Shadows and different colors.
Yeah.
Can you point to all the different shades on the blanket?
Right there.
What I did for Elijah today was I broke down lesson 80 into two parts because it was super long. We did part of it yesterday and we did the other half of it today. So he did this part yesterday. We did these today, and we looked at the painting today as well. All right, we're getting Elijah started with math. He's got a quiz today. Quiz 10. Kaylin is working on her word search. I might just have you do language arts with me right now since we're going to have an early lunch, and also Zoe is sleeping right now still, so we might want to take advantage of that. All right, now looking through Kaylin's language arts for today, she's on this writer's workshop, but since it's Friday and I'm probably going to split this up into a couple different days, I'm going to go ahead and move on and just put a little bookmark there so that we can get to that on Monday. I'm going to go ahead and move on to spelling rule number 5. Words ending in X are an exception and they are never doubled. So if a word is ending in an X, it's never doubled. Words ending in a silent E do not follow the rule because there are two vowels in the syllable. The silent E should be dropped before adding the vowel suffix. And you do not have to add any more consonants if a word already ends in a double consonant. So, yeah. We're going to go ahead and dictate some of these and see if you can write these down when I read them to you. All I do is close my eyes, and you're just standing there with your perfect smile. Elijah is finishing up math, and then we are going to have an early lunch today. So since it is Friday and we're all feeling a bit sluggish today, we are going to read out of our space book, and then we're going to read a devotion out of this indescribable devotional that goes along with our science unit that we're doing. We had a couple activities planned for today, but I think instead we are going to get outside and enjoy this beautiful day and do a little nature walk and maybe do some nature bingo from our nature books. So
bingo.
That'll be fun. So yeah, we'll do that and then we'll come back in and maybe have a treat.
Yeah.
All right. First thing first is coffee, because I am dragging you guys like I'm no joke. I can't even talk. Actually going to do is I am using the Good and the Beautiful. Yeah, we're going to go bye-bye, sweetheart.
She's getting it.
We are. We're going to go bye-bye, sweetie. Just hold on. We're going to use this nature notebook, and I'm going to use this as kind of a template for bingo. So that we can just explore and discover things outside. I'm not going to make everybody bring their nature notebooks with them. We're just going to go take a nice walk out in the sunshine. Okay, we are going on a little nature hike. Yeah, doggy gets you. Come on, go.
Hey, Bean.
Where? Look at those pretty flowers. Are they up off of this tree?
Yeah.
Aww, how pretty. This looks so pretty. Oh, I love seeing that.
Well, it smells like spring.
I know, I love it. What is it? Where you going? Yeah. Come here, honey. Come here. Here is a interesting fact. We live right next door to my in-laws, and they actually converted their old horse barn into a church. So we've got like a little country church out here, and it's not, you know, it's not a big church, but it's still like such a good feeling to have on our property. It's literally a small little walk away. You running? Ready,
set, go! All right, walking back home. Got my coffee still, waiting on these slow pokes. It's so beautiful out. It's still a bit chilly. My eyes are watering, but oh, I could get used to days like this. Okay, well, I think that we're gonna end this here. It was just a nice, relaxing day of homeschool. Homeschool doesn't have to be completely like crazy and a whole bunch of stuff just jam-packed into the day. On days like today, we're all a little tired, had kind of a rough night last night. It was nice to just be able to get outside, get some vitamin D, get into nature. And I hope you enjoyed this day in the life of our homeschooling day. Like I said, it wasn't anything wildly special today, but it was what a typical day looks like for us. And we're so excited because next month for science, we're going to be doing the Gather Round Oceans Unit study. I know it's an all... Woody. It's an all-encompassing unit study.
Mommy.
It has like a whole bunch of different subjects into one, except for math. But we're gonna try to make it work into our homeschooling day somehow, and I'm super excited to try it. So stay tuned for that next month. And yeah, let me know down below if you like these kinds of videos, and I will do more day in the lives. Like I said, we're kind of in a coronavirus outbreak right now. And then before that was the flu outbreak, so we've been kind of hermity this winter and homebound, but we've been making it work. We've been just trying to stay healthy and not spread anything around. So I hope that you guys enjoy this. Give it a like and subscribe to my channel if you're interested in this kind of content, because I have so much more homeschooling content coming to you soon. And comment down below because I love to get to know you. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.
You look so beautiful. So lucky to be yours. And you're taking